Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip. Today I will answer a question about calling a function on an Oracle database that returns a sysref cursor. But before we start, please subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified about new Hibernate tip videos. I upload a new one every week. So here's the question. We are using an Oracle database and I need to call a function that returns a sysref cursor. I tried to call it as a native query, but it didn't work. Is there any way to call this function with JPA or Hibernate? You can call such a function by declaring a Hibernate-specific named native query, which extends JPA's named native query. Let's take a look at an example. Here you can see the database function that we will call with Hibernate. It returns all reviews of a book with a given ID. The main difference between this function and other functions that you can call in a JPQA query is its return type. The sysref cursor is a pointer to the result of a query. The caller of the function can use this pointer to read as many records from the result set as he wants. It also makes the function a little bit harder to call via JPA. You can use JPA's native query to call functions that return values of simple types, like int or string. Unfortunately, that doesn't work for functions that return Oracle's sysref cursor. But Hibernate's own org-hibernate.annotations.named-native-query annotation allows you to call these functions. You can see the annotation here. It extends JPA's named native query annotation by the callable attribute. If you set it to true, you tell Hibernate that this query calls a database function or stored procedure. One additional pitfall you should be aware of is that Hibernate 5.2 requires you to define a result mapping. If you don't specify a result class or reference a result set mapping, it throws a not yet implemented exception. In this example, my function selects all columns from the review table. I use the result class attribute to tell Hibernate to map each record to a managed review entity. The result set mapping attribute references an SQL result set mapping definition. It enables you to define how the query result shall be mapped to entities, POJOs, and scalar values. You can use it to create mappings of any complexity. I explained the different mapping options in great details in a series of articles on my blog. I will add the link to it to the video description. Okay, let's finish this example by executing the query and calling the getReviews function. You can call Hibernate's named native query in the same way as you call any other named query. You only need to call the createNamedQuery method of your entity manager with the name of the query, set all bind parameter values, and call the getSingleResult or getResultList method. When you execute this test case and activate the logging of SQL statements, you can see the SQL statement that calls the database function in the log file. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!